If you never used the Company Training Academy for creating a cybersecurity training and awareness program, then this video is for you. So I'll show you how to use this company-wide cybersecurity training platform to create training programs for a company that is based in a couple of countries and how to create training programs in several languages covering several different frameworks. And after you watch this video, you'll have a clear idea on what should be your first steps when using this platform. As an example, let's take the following scenario. Let's say that you are an IT company, a managed service provider, and that you have around 150 employees that are based in three offices in three countries. So US, Netherlands, and France. And let's say that your US office is certified against ISO 27001 and that your company is classified as a critical infrastructure provider in the European Union. In other words, this means that you have to comply with ISO 27001, but also with NIS2 and GDPR. On top of that, you also have employees that are speaking three different languages. And even though the employees in France and Netherlands are fluent in English, they are still more comfortable with their native languages, so French and Dutch. And let's say that you want to take the following approach, that you want to separate the training for four groups of people, so for senior management, for mid-level management, for IT employees, and then for all the other employees, so that you want to keep the training role-specific. On top of this, let's say that you want to cover each country with their own native language. Also, you want to cover your Dutch and French offices with NIS2 and GDPR, whereas you want to cover your US office with ISO 27001. And finally, you want these trainings to take away the least amount of productive time from your employees, so you want this training to be delivered once a week and that it takes a maximum of, let's say, 10 minutes per employee. Let's see now how you can achieve this using Company Training Academy. Okay, this is how Company Training Academy looks like once you log in. So you can see the training programs here. These training programs were created by the platform automatically so that you can get a feeling on how this looks like. Okay, now let's create a training program. So you can do this by going here, training programs, and click create a new training. What you'll see here is a wizard that takes you actually through the whole process. So we want to set up a first training out of four for the US office, right? ISO 27001 training for the senior management. So we select a framework 27001, and then here you see already predefined or suggested training programs for each specific role. So we want this one, 27001 training and awareness for senior management, and click continue. And so here we can actually play around with the title. So we'll just add here US office so that we know what this was about. Country, so you want United States, and English as a language, click continue. And then the system will automatically suggest you what are the most appropriate topics for ISO 27001 training and awareness. So as you can see here, we have lots of these cybersecurity awareness videos, but also you will see ISO 27001 videos. What is 27001 benefits, leadership and commitment, and so on. And these are filtered out by the role. So we are showing here only the videos that are relevant for the senior management, not all the videos. Of course, if you don't like any of these, you can simply remove them, or you can actually rearrange the sequence so that you want some of these videos to be shown, let's say, earlier in the sequence and so on. Okay, then you click continue, and then you define how often you want to see. So as we mentioned, so let's say once per week, and let's say that the best day to display this is on Thursday. You define the start of the program, and let's say that you want to repeat this every 2 years so that these people do not forget about these topics. And then click continue, and then you enter the email addresses of the people that you want to be part of this training program. And then of course you can enter several email addresses here, and then you simply click continue, and then you define what you want these attendees to see. Do you want them to see only the videos, or videos and quizzes and test questions? So let's say because this is a senior management, you don't want to test them, you just want to allow them to go through these quizzes, and then you activate the program. And as you can see, now this program will be displayed here in your dashboard. Now let's set up quickly other training programs. So you want to go for 27001, you want this time to go for the mid-level management, click continue, add here US office, and then click continue. And then again, the lessons here will be slightly different because this is not the senior management, but again, you can define which lessons you want. and basically go through this whole process again, similar to what you did for the senior management. Now, in this case, you might actually go for videos and quizzes and test questions so that you want to test these people, since this is not about senior management, and you simply activate the program. And then I go for the next one, and I want to create this training program, security and awareness training program for IT employees. So here I select general cybersecurity, and I define that this needs to go towards IT employees. Click continue. Again, change this here. And then here you will see only the videos about cybersecurity awareness and training, not about 27001. And then you click continue, and again define the sequence, and define the how often this needs to be displayed. Let's say you want them to be displayed on Tuesday. Click continue. And as you can see now, you have these four training programs for your US office. Now let's set up the trainings for your office in France. So again, click new training. This time you go for NIS 2. And you want to go for the senior management first. Click continue. Now you select France and you select here French language. Click continue. And then, as you will see already, all the lessons are now in French. And you see here, this is general cybersecurity. And here you will see now lessons around NIS 2. So everything is included here. And then you set up the rest of the program similar as you do in English. And as you can see, this first program for French office, it's in French. And let's set up now the rest of the training programs for a French office. Okay, and this is how it looks like when you set up these four training programs for a French office. Now let's add also these GDPR training programs for French office, since this is also what you want to train your employees for. So again, create new training. This time you select the GDPR and you select this one for senior management. Click continue. Again, you select France. Now, currently this program is only available in English, but we will add other languages very soon. So in a couple of months, you will see this also in French. But let me just specify this is the French office and then click continue. As you can see, there are already some lessons here and all these lessons are really appropriate for senior management. So click continue and then set up the rest of the program similarly to other. Now here, I'm not going to do this once a week. I'm going to do this, let's say, once every 2 weeks, so that it's not too often when compared to these other training programs. Again, I specify which day. And let's say that I do not want to repeat this one. And of course, I set the rest of the program as with others. Okay, so as you can see now, I created these four training programs for GDPR for French office for these different groups. And I created also these security awareness and NIS 2 training and awareness programs for French office. And I also have these for US office. And basically, this is also what you repeat doing for the Dutch office in the same way. So as you can see, it's very easy to create a particular training program, and especially if you want to target it towards a certain audience. Now, in most cases, you won't have such a complicated situation with several standards and several languages and locations, but I wanted to show you how easy it is actually to organize training, even if you do have such difficult requirements. Of course, once you activate all of these programs, it's very easy to add and remove users, create reports, handle the users, reset this progress, delete the program, edit, and so on. Okay, let's see now how this looks like from the end user point of view, from the attendee point of view. They will receive emails typically 1 or 2 days before the lesson needs to be watched, and they will actually see the title of the lesson and basically where to log in. Now, in the system itself, you can actually adapt any of these elements. So basically the from name, the signature here, the text here, so you can all adapt this for your specific needs for your company. Okay, once the user clicks the link and logs into the system, he or she will basically see this kind of a screen. So the user simply needs to click this play button and go through the whole video.
Article 21 of the NIS 2 directive requires.
Once the video reaches the end, then the user will be able to answer these quizzes and tests. So let me show you how this works. So let's say that the user wants to answer this question. He or she can actually check the answer and see if this is correct, and also check the explanation for each of these answers, why they are correct, why they are not correct, and to basically reinforce their learning. When you scroll down to this test, you can actually do the same thing. You can answer, but there is no feedback because this test serves as a measurement method for the management actually to follow on if someone has understood everything that was presented in this lesson. And then the user simply needs to click finish training or click attend the next lesson if he or she wants to go through the next video right away. Okay, I'll show you now how to customize these emails that are sent. So you go for this email notification settings. And here you can see these six different types of emails that are being sent, which you can edit and change according to what you need. So let's say that I want to edit this lesson reminder. And here I want to change the from name. Let's say that you want to put this your company name here. So let's say, I don't know, Test Incorporated. And the subject, let's say that you want to leave it as it is. You want to probably enter your email address here. Okay, and then dear colleague, the deadline for watching the lesson is due. Let's say that you want to write a more precise in 1 day and that you want to change this here. And send notification 1 day before the lesson is due. And then you simply save changes. And then this is how the attendees will see these emails that they will receive. Let me also show you how you add your own logo to this platform. So you go for company settings, you define your company name, and you upload your logo. And then you basically click update and you will see that this logo is now uploaded. Now this logo will be displayed in your PDF reports. So any report that you download will have your company name there and it will have this logo. So when you want to see reports and records of these trainings, then you can simply go here for user management and reporting. And here you can see for each user in detail what he or she has been doing by clicking here. So you will see all the lessons for which this person was assigned to and what was the test result. Here we can see that this attendee has not yet attended, but if he or she did, then you would see exactly what has happened there. So this is on the individual level. When I go back, you can go for these training reports, which provide you a summary. So basically here, you would actually be able to see all the students and their success, and you would be able to download these reports in PDF. And similarly, you have this summary report about lessons and also summary report about training program. So that you have actually a very good idea on how your attendees are doing, how your lessons are doing, how your training programs are doing. Okay, hope this was helpful. And let me know in the comments below if you have any questions on how to set up training and awareness programs, and I'll answer you as quick as I can. And to access this Company Training Academy free trial, click the link in the description below, and you'll be able to test out all the features and build all of these programs that I was showing you, and also send these invitations to your students so that you can see actually how it works in reality. See also my next video that explains most common questions about Company Training Academy, and you'll find the link below. And if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, and you can also subscribe to my YouTube channel not to miss any of my new videos, and I publish videos about cybersecurity compliance and governance every week. Thanks for watching!